different types of hair loss. There are different types of hair loss, the three most common of which are alopecia areata, alopecia androgenetica and telogen effluvium. None of these conditions has to be permanent. Hair can regrow if you can find out why it fell out in the first place and then treat the underlying cause in a way that does not compromise the body's normal functioning. You may have lost the hair on your head only, but that doesn't necessarily mean that treating the scalp will resolve the problem. Hair loss needs to be tackled systemically, and understanding what has caused your hair to shed over and above the normal 70 to 100 hairs a day is a first step to finding a remedy. Alopecia areata. The word alopecia was first used by Hippocrates and means fox mange. The word areata means round. Alopecia areata is a non-negation scarring, inflammatory form of hair loss and occurs in men, women and children. At the moment, the most commonly offered explanation for the occurrence of this hair problem is that it is an autoimmune disease, although neither doctors nor dermatologists nor trichologists, hair specialists, know why it is happening. In an autoimmune disease, the body's immune system becomes overactive and starts attacking its own tissues. In the case of alopecia areata, the tissues that are being targeted are the hair follicles. Some people who suffer from alopecia areata also have problems with their nails, which are made from the same material as hair, keratin. Alopecia areata usually starts with one small round patch where hair falls out. This can happen overnight. The bald patch mostly shows itself on the head, but it can also occur in a man's beard or anywhere else on a person's body where hair grows. This bald patch can stay the same size and then gradually begin to grow hair again, or it can become bigger, with more bald patches turning up. A sign that this type of alopecia is active and expanding are the so-called exclamation marks on the borders of the bald patch. Exclamation marks are hairs that look like they have broken off. In about 30% of cases, the bald patches become worse to such an extent that all the hair on the head falls out. This condition is called alopecia totalis. If all the hair on the head as well as all other body hair falls out, the condition is called alopecia universalis. A particular form of alopecia areata is ophiacic alopecia. The word ophiacic comes from the Greek word ophis for snake and means serpentine or snake-like. In the context of hair loss, this means that the hair loss pattern occurs around the head horizontally, that is, hair falls out in patches along the front hairline, above the ears and along the base of the hairline along the neck region, so that only the hair on top of the head is left. This is a form of alopecia which is particularly difficult to treat, but it can be done, although it will take a long time. Alopecia areata can also occur only in eyebrows, eyelashes or a man's beard. The received opinion is that in these cases, the alopecia is usually confined to that area and doesn't spread to the scalp. However, a couple of cases where it did, so you are encouraged to react promptly once you find any bald areas in your eyebrows, eyelashes or in your beard. The quickest way of finding out what is causing the patches is to see a kinesiologist or to have a hair sample test done. Alopecia areata can last for many years. With some people, hair grows in one place only to fall out in another. In some people, the hair all grows back only to fall out again in round patches a few months or years later. When hair grows back, it usually does so as vellus hair, which is very fine and without color. Normal color and texture only begin to develop later on. Some people experience changes in their hair color during or after an episode of hair loss, and sometimes these color changes can be permanent. The clearest way of identifying alopecia areata is to take a small scalp sample for microscopic examination. If the dermatologist finds that there is inflammation of the hair follicles, he or she can diagnose the condition as alopecia areata. This procedure is actually not necessary. If hair comes out in round patches which have exclamation mark-shaped broken hairs along the borders, you can be sure that you have alopecia areata. In my experience, any form of alopecia areata, no matter whether it is just one patch or the loss of all the hair on head and body, is a sign of heavy toxicity in the body. Detox has to happen slowly and with great support of the kidneys, adrenals and the liver. Health kinesiology treatment and nutrient support has to be tailor-made to the individual. Toxins have to be identified and removed with natural supplements so that eventually, the body can recover and grow hair again on a permanent base. A GUC hair sample test can help establish the underlying toxicity that is causing the hair loss and determine exactly which supplements are necessary to remove the toxins. Alopecia androgenetica. This type of hair loss is also called male pattern hair loss. It shows itself in men as gradually receding temples and thinning of the hair on the crown. Depending on the individual man's disposition, the thinning temple hair recedes all the way to the crown and the hair on top of the head recedes all the way down to the back of the head, leaving a horseshoe-shaped fringe around the back of the head. In women, alopecia androgenetica commences either by thinning hair in the crown area, sometimes by receding temples or a widening gap where you part your hair which slowly spreads over the top of the head. In women, there is usually no total hair loss on the crown area. Instead, hair grows only very finely so that the scalp can be seen through the hair. In both men and women, this condition is thought to be caused by genetic factors and/or hormonal imbalance, and conventional treatment will deal with these two factors, using chemical substances in the form of tablets and lotions to reset the faulty genes and/or hormones. Having worked over the last 12 years with clients who have this form of hair loss, it was found that the true cause of androgenetic alopecia is not genetic. If it were, how come natural supplements are able to help the hair regrow? When checking a client's hair sample, whether it be a man or a woman, toxins of one kind or another were found. Very often these are toxic metals, invasive organisms such as fungi and parasites, and/or food intolerances that prevent the body from functioning properly. Once these issues have been addressed with natural remedies, hair can start to regrow in many cases. This means that the hair loss was not due to a faulty gene but was only a symptom of toxicity in the body. Telogen effluvium. As you already know, telogen is the phase in the hair cycle where hair becomes loose in the hair follicle and is shed easily during washing or combing. The word effluvium means flow out and is used here in the sense of shedding. Telogen effluvium is different from alopecia androgenetica in that hair is shed evenly over the whole head and sometimes also over other parts of the body. Normally, only about 10% of hair is in the telogen stage at any one time, whereas most of the hair is in the growing stage. Clearly, if there is a higher percentage of hair falling out compared to hair growing, this will make your head of hair look thin and unattractive. We speak of telogen effluvium if a significantly increased percentage of hair follicles are in a resting phase than would normally be expected. In some people, anagen effluvium develops as well as or instead of telogen effluvium. Anagen effluvium means that the hair is falling out during its growing phase. This is most commonly observed during chemotherapy or radiation therapy for cancer, but it also occurs as a result of poisoning with arsenic or thallium salts, for example. Arsenic is contained in fungicides, cattle and sheep dips, paints and pigments and wood preservatives. Thallium is contained in, among other things, optical lenses, jewelry, dyes and recreational drugs. Telogen or anagen effluvium usually first show themselves several months after a trigger factor has occurred. The trigger factor can consist of physical or emotional stress or hormonal imbalances. Just as with androgenetic alopecia, toxins are often found at the bottom of this type of hair loss. This can easily be verified with a GUC test with a hair sample. Toxic metals, invasive organisms and rude intolerances, together with electromagnetic field disturbances and some other factors, can cause the hair to change its growing cycle and prevent nutrient uptake into the hair roots. Other forms of hair loss. There are two other forms of hair loss which are not due to illness but are self-inflicted. Trichotillomania is an obsessive compulsive disorder where a person pulls out hairs from their body. This can be either hair from the head, but also eyelashes, eyebrows, body hair or even pubic hair. If this hair plucking and pulling goes on over many years, the hair may not grow back again as the follicles are too damaged. This problem occurs mainly in women and is strongly associated with anxiety and stress disorders, and these have to be dealt with first and foremost to deal with the problem. There are usually very good results with hypnotherapy for clients with this particular problem. The other self-inflicted condition is traction alopecia. Here, the hair is pulled into a very tight hairstyle, often severely scraped back from the front and tied at the back. The hair loss occurs in those areas of the scalp where the hair is being pulled particularly harshly. In traction alopecia, the hair is virtually pulled out of the scalp. A simple remedy is to stop putting this strain on the hair follicles by changing the hairstyle.